It says recording, top left. Okay, yeah. You want to pause it, press that centre button. It's going to look reasonably similar, I would expect. Just the slight variances, obviously one in age and two being a Swift instead of a Bailey. So on the front end, you've got a stabiliser, yep, which you may have had on your last one, I would have thought. Obviously, toe ball needs to be grease-free and paint-free.
Yeah.
Because it works on friction, so you're happy with that, what that does, what it's
yeah,
there for.
Yeah, the other one's nice and rusty.
Yeah. I expect it. Grease-free. Breakaway cable. Excellent. Is that the same? Yeah, you're happy with what they do?
Yeah, absolutely.
ATC you may have had on the last one. So what we've got with that one is it works alongside that. So it's stuck, to do with the stability of your vehicle.
Yeah.
So what that will do is detect movement like that, so swaying. And then it will apply the brakes. Only slowly, it's not going to just go.
Yeah, you like just stop.
In front of the windscreen. Yeah. It applies it slowly for a period of about 7 seconds.
Okay.
So, what you do, imagine the car and the caravan are roughly, say, that kind of angle.
Yeah.
What it does is it just slows the caravan down and then the car just pulls it straight. Gotcha. So, it's a really basic system. Yeah. Obviously, it's very effective.
Yeah, perfect.
That's an indicator like to say what condition it's in when you start it up. So, it actually runs off your vehicle electrics. So, okay, when you plug it in, obviously for your lights, whatever else, it will supply power to that.
Yep.
You'll hear it do a manual test. Okay. Obviously you'll hear that when we do that.
Yeah.
And then it'll indicate a light there. Green light, solid, that means it's okay.
Yeah.
Ready to go. Green light flashing means it's partly done its test but not quite finished.
Yeah.
Normally from travelling from here to the gate, about 100 yards or so, it will
sorted.
Go solid and complete it. Red light, obviously problem. What you do is just unplug your electrics.
Yeah.
Obviously see if it resets. So plug them back in. If it doesn't reset, you may still be able to travel, but the system won't be operating. Cool. So obviously you're going to need to check at some point.
Yeah.
And before you move, make sure the caravan will move, because obviously it works on brakes.
Yeah.
If the brakes have been applied, obviously you're not going to be able to move it.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Okay. It also will have a flashing red one.
Yeah.
So likelihood it has applied the brakes. Again, you can unplug it, see if it will reset.
Okay.
And again, move it. If it obviously moves, you can again travel that system, which to either get someone out to it, reset it, or whatever. Or there's like a rod. It goes between the brakes and the system that you can remove, which obviously means climbing underneath. If you're capable of doing that.
And I presume things like that would be on our warranty, would they? Things go wrong with it.
Right. Obviously, gas locker. This you may not have had on your previous one, which is a dual control. Okay, so you can have two cylinders connected if you wanted to.
Okay.
Obviously, whichever that one's pointed to is normally where the gas is coming from.
Yeah.
So this is our pigtail one. Obviously, we need to get one that fits your particular gas.
Cool.
Okay, there's an indicator up there when it's green, that means it's got gas in it. Put gas pressure to it. If obviously it's red, then obviously you haven't.
Is there an amber so you know it's about to run out?
No. That's the only good thing about this one is if you've got two connected, you've got it connected to there, obviously one you can change over manually.
Yeah.
What we'll also do is if you've used all that gas up, because you can guarantee it will run out just
in the shower,
or whatever, it will automatically start taking gas from the other one, but that one will still be red.
Okay.
So you have to check, you know, quite obviously every now and again, make sure to see if it has turned red, you need to turn that across to the other one.
Gotcha.
Otherwise, you could end up emptying both of them without realising.
Yeah.
And you've got two empty ones instead of one empty one.
Gotcha.
Okay. And that'll pull out. Obviously, it just clicks in. Water pump is on board, so the water pump isn't actually on the end of that, it's just a pipe.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, right.
Okay. That is your vent for your boiler.
That comes with the caravan, eh?
That pipe comes with the caravan.
Yeah, cool. Yeah.
That is your boiler vent.
Yeah.
Okay, on gas. On the previous one, you probably had a boiler. Well, you would have had a boiler and a fire.
Yeah.
And if you had the one with the cover, you would have had to take that cover off if you wanted to use it on gas.
That's right.
This is just that's how it is. So it's an open ended cover, so you don't need to take any covers off.
Right.
Okay. Happy that bit so far?
Yeah.
Good. Obviously, this is our battery connected at the moment.
Yeah.
Obviously, 240 connected as well. So you've got a 240 connection. We've also got an aerial connecting point there as well. You see that there?
Oh, cool. What's that for tele?
Yeah. So you can plug an external aerial into the van.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Okay, if you...
Because we have got a satellite for our old van, because... Excellent. Is this the leisure battery?
No, that's our battery.
Yeah,
yeah, that's where the leisure battery would go. Okay. That is our...
Is that permanently charging, because it's got the solar panels?
Yeah,
or open?
Yeah, well, obviously apart from when it's dark.
Yeah. So I...
Toilet cassette.
Yeah.
Things are the same.
Yeah, very good.
Yeah. And then obviously, what you got there is a drain for your flush tank. So that pipe that's on...
Okay, great.
Pipe this on the little ledge.
Yeah.
So obviously making sure you're draining that for winter.
Yeah.
So what you can do is you use the flush to flush it into the tank and just drain the last little bit like that from there. Yeah. Otherwise you could be there for ages waiting for that to drain out.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Okay. Access. Oh, which is locked. Once you've got a bike rack on the back, just be very careful. You are limited to how much weight you can have on that. I think it's around about 50 or 60 kilo.
Okay.
probably the rack itself would take more weight than that, but you've got to be obviously considerate of the wall itself, obviously taking that kind of weight. So
yeah, 50-60 kilo. Okay. Yeah,
what are our bikes?
50-60. Yeah, so just
we've got
be careful.
Two standard bikes, so hopefully they'd be.
Yeah, but some you can have some really hefty bikes.
Oh, okay.
Some of mountain bikes, depending on what bike you've got.
Yeah,
okay. Can be quite hefty. Yeah. Some are just so you can pick up with one finger.
Oh, you mean it'd actually pull off the caravan, would it?
Yeah, well, not necessarily pull off the caravan, but it might damage. No, it's still fine. Right, so we've got 240 outlet, barbecue point. And that's locked as well.
Is that the storage?
Yeah. So we've obviously got keys. So you've got a big key, it does mostly don't check them, there's always at risk that they may come off.
What's that, 130 newton?
That is your setting, if you had a torque wrench, that is a setting that needs to be set at to check.
Fine.
Okay. On this one. So the control panel's asleep, I can press any button, it'll just light it up. So that's your 12 volt system on and off, so that's your master switch.
Cool.
Water pump switch, 240 switch, press switch. 240 indicator and ledger battery indicator.
Yeah.
If you saw that on there, then pressure view levels, that's telling you condition of your ledger battery.
Cool.
Okay. Very so you switch your 12 volts on and off, it just switched. Pressing.
Okay.
12 volts off, 12 volts on.
The vehicle batteries, that's on the car?
Yes. So if it's connected, you could obviously see if that.
How it charges?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's good.
All right. It was, going back quite a few years where. Used to use the car battery quite often with a caravan.
Okay.
Obviously, for some reason, they've still got this option with it.
Yeah.
So you could actually, if your ledger battery was flat, you could actually use your car battery, but.
Fine.
You're likely you're going to flatten that battery and you're not going home.
Absolutely, definitely.
Probably not a good idea.
No.
Okay.
Cool.
Right.
Any other?
I'll show you that
in a minute. Right.
So, obviously normal next procedure is getting the water up and running.
Cool.
So, just down here on the right is your boiler. Which is a combined.
You want a biscuit?
So underneath here. That's your boiler in the corner.
Okay.
Chris?
I am.
Yeah. So the boiler will obviously provide heat for your room, which is central heating around the room.
So where's the heat coming from?
It's coming from behind the seats mainly.
Okay. So, but all around the caravan.
Yeah. All the way around the caravan. Yeah.
There are all caravans, which is there,
it's
always cold.
It was a bit cold up the end for the kids.
Oh, it does, yeah. That's it, we get with a longer caravan. Obviously, the thing with that is you add vents, which went underneath the caravan and come back up the other end.
Yeah.
So as it went out, it's probably cooling it down to get when it comes back up the other end, it's cool.
Absolutely.
But with this system, it stays inside the van.
Perfect.
So it's obviously not losing heat out of it, because obviously it's insulated.
Lovely.
Right, so what we've got down here is your drain. So the other plug down there.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, it's probably somewhat similar to what you had on your previous van.
It is, yeah.
So obviously that will drain your water out of your hot water tank and obviously your cold and hot taps. Okay. What we've got here is your consumer unit. Heating the hot water.
Yep.
So that is for your heater. That is just to give you power to your boiler. So it's just an isolating switch. So that's obviously off. That's on. That's just a spare. Even though it looks the same, it's not connected.
Okay.
Charger switch. So with that switched on and your 240 connected, with your charger here, that will charge your ledger battery.
Okay.
Reverse polarity, if you go on the continent with it, they tend to wire things differently than us. And if you plug your electrics in, come in, have a look. If that is lit, so it's just a light, that means it is reverse. You're going to need an adapter to operate off their electrics.
Oh, okay. What countries that normally happen?
More or less all countries apart from us.
Oh, really?
But there are certain sites now that I have got the same kind of ratio of power than what we've got, but obviously they're still quite a bit lower. France tends to be one of them. Okay.
Which fuse is there?
They're your trip switches. There's your info note there to tell you what they're connected to.
Ah, brilliant. Yeah.
Trip switch there, that's your tester, a bit similar to your consumer unit at home. Obviously, what you should do when you plug your 240 in, come in and press that button just to trip it, just to make sure it is tripping, because obviously it's a safety trip. Okay, this side is your 12-volt fuses. Cool. You've got info note there to tell what they're connected to.
Excellent.
Then, let me see that there. System shutdown button. What that does is shut down all the 12-volt systems. When you're in storage, it's probably the best thing to do is shut that down. That will stop your battery being drained down. Okay?
Shut what down?
It shuts your 12-volt system down, so that'll shut down all the power being drained out of your battery.
Okay, so what do I need to do?
That button there.
Oh, sorry, right. Okay.
Yeah. So obviously you need to turn it back on again.
System shutdown. Yeah.
So you need to turn that back on again if you want to use it, obviously.
Yeah, perfect.
Okay, and that's your pump there. So that's your onboard pump.
Perfect.
So that will draw the water out into your hot water tank.
Excellent.
Or into your system. All right. So
I've got biscuits in the sink.
Oh, yeah.
That's right. Oh, yeah, it's probably best to have crumbs down there. Right, obviously, what I've done is. No. I'm going to switch the 12 volt switch. That switches your water pump on. So you've got light inside, you've got water pump on.
Yep.
So get your. Be exactly the same getting the water system in. Because I unplug the plug outside, it'll sputter a bit of air into it. Obviously, when you start up from when it's been drained down, obviously that's what you're going to get to start with.
Yeah,
anyway.
Of course. Yeah.
Yeah. To fill your hot water tank, exactly the same. Across to the hot side.
Yeah.
And then obviously expel all the air out. You have these 10 litres of air coming out from that tank.
Oh, wow.
If you've drained it already.
Yeah.
As if you want to put your finger under there, but it's quite warm.
Pretty toasty.
Okay. Nice. So shows you that's okay.
Yeah.
Obviously, do the same with each tap. Because otherwise the pump will continue to run for a while if you've got air in the system.
Yeah.
Obviously you just heard it there, it's just switched itself off.
Gotcha.
So it's a pressurised system. Obviously the more air in it, more it will compress and more it will run.
Yep.
If there's water, it'll shut off a lot quicker.
Gotcha. Okay.
Okay.
Perfect.
Right, happy with that?
Yeah, good. All good.
Well, I'll show you your heating system next.
Yeah.
That's your on-off button there.
Very good.
Okay. That there is a circulation pump, so that's what's circulating your heating around your van.
Right.
That there is to show you've got 240 connected. It's not saying it's you are using electric, it just says you're connected. So that orange button on the consumer unit, if that was switched off, that plug wouldn't be there and you wouldn't be able to use it on electric.
Gotcha.
Okay. And the next one along is your temperature of your room.
Cool. Would it then automatically start using the gas?
If you've got a gas switched on, yeah.
Yeah, cool.
If you're just trying to use it on electric, it's not going to operate.
Okay.
Okay. So if you want to change anything, press the menu button.
Yeah.
Comes up with your next line. So the top one is your temperature.
Nice.
Okay, so just plus or minus, maximum 30 degrees, lowest is 5 degrees.
Brilliant.
You can't, if you're heating your water, you can't physically turn the heating off as such, so it's not just like a switch off. All you do is just bring the temperature below the temperature of your room.
Yeah.
So we see the room temperature there is 24.
Yeah.
I just set it to 23.
Yeah.
Circulation pumps off, that stopped the heat being pumped around the van.
Great.
Okay?
Okay.
So obviously if you want it to run, obviously you need to bring it above the room temperature. Okay? See that there?
Fine.
The next one is your water heating. So that's water heating off.
Yeah.
Press the plus button that goes green, half a triangle coloured in, that's your normal running for your water heating.
Right.
What you can do is boost it by pressing the plus button again, then your full triangle coloured in.
Cool.
What that will do is concentrate all the heating on the hot water.
Brilliant.
Which he's doing now. We go back to the main menu, or the main screen, see the circulation pump's off. So what it's done is shut the circulation pump off.
Yeah.
To keep all the heat in the boiler, make sure that give it that extra heat in the hot water tank.
Brilliant.
Okay. What that will do will run for 30 minutes.
Yeah.
And then it will revert back to normal running, or unless you obviously do it manually.
Yeah.
And then it will, if you've got the heating in the range, then it will heating will come back on.
Cool.
Okay. The next one is your energy. So that's electric off, 1 kilowatt, 2 kilowatt, or 3 kilowatt.
Cool.
That's gas on at the moment. That's gas off.
Wow.
Okay.
And energy, what would you normally have it on?
Right, if you're in the summer, most of the time it's just going to be water heating.
Yeah.
Okay, so you may get away with 2 or 3 kilowatts. It will be well sufficient to keep your water heated.
Yeah.
Okay. In the winter, you may struggle on electric alone, or this time of year when it's a bit cooler, you need obviously heating running.
Yeah.
The best thing to do is run it on electric and gas. The other thing you've got to remember is obviously the bollard you're connected to has got a limit of 16 amps. Yep. Most of the time, you may have lower than that.
Yeah.
If you start drawing 3 kilowatts out on that, and you've obviously got your ring going, and you've got that going.
Yeah.
If you've got a kettle, if you've got a hairdryer, all that will add up.
Yeah.
And the likelihood it will trip that. So if it's starting to do something like that, what you can do is just reduce it, say, down to 1 or 2 kilowatts plus gas.
Yeah.
What that will then do is use both energies to get up to temperature.
Yeah.
Then it will shut the gas off.
Yeah.
And continue to run on electric.
Great.
Unless someone like yourself leaves the door wide open, cold blast of air, temperature drops.
Yeah.
Gas will come back on again.
Gotcha.
Just to get back up to temperature, or use all the hot water.
Very good.
Okay. The other thing I didn't quite mention was on the boost, you may want to boost it just if you're going to use a shower on board.
Yeah.
Boost it to give you that extra hot water.
Yeah.
When you need it.
Cool.
Okay.
Excellent. And the thing on the right is that settings. Isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, that's the next one I'll show you.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
Are you happy with that? That's the main. That's the main. Get it up and running.
Yeah.
Perfect. Are you happy with it?
Yeah. That's all good. Yeah.
Yeah. Good. Yeah. Okay. So what I'll do, there's a further menu which is quite a few things on that, which I'll just go through them just to show you what they are.
Yeah.
I won't go into too much depth because there's a lot of
information. Yeah, absolutely.
There.
Yeah.
Okay. So what we got, obviously, there's a few different timers on this.
Yeah.
So obviously you need to set the clock first, obviously. So the time and date is that one there.
Yeah.
This one is what is called reduced temperature for night time. So obviously that's what.